In this episode today, I'm going to cover the basics of what Stimulus.js is. So that's what it is and when it's useful. Before I start, I just want to remind you to smash that like button and click subscribe. It helps me so much and it's really, really, really appreciated. So what are we going to cover? I'm going to give you a quick history of Stimulus. I'm going to show you some of its code. I'm going to give you a heads up as to when it's useful. And I'm also going to quickly run through how to set it up in Rails. The idea of this video is, by the end of it, you should have enough confidence to just kind of give it a try and make your own thoughts up about it. So where does it come from? So when I first started Rails, about 2010 time, the options were write CoffeeScript, which was a horrible language. At the time it was great, but now I look back on it in horror. Write jQuery, which was great. I really liked jQuery, but it was very hard to keep it contained because generally it kind of got everywhere and we ended up with spaghetti balls of JavaScript. We did also have the early days of like frameworks such as Backbone and others, maybe even Ember. We're kind of there about, but they didn't really get a good footing in. And then fast forward to the modern days, we have like React and Vue, and they're great, but they favor a lot of rendering on the client side. And the big drawback of rendering on the client side for me is it's not as quick as just firing HTML down the pipe to the user and having the browser just render that. Browsers are really good at rendering HTML and CSS really quickly, and doing a lot with JavaScript is not a good idea, in my opinion. So in around 2018 time, Basecamp released Stimulus. They were working on Hey at the time, and they wanted something to give them that little bit of front-end jazz to kind of make their websites nice, but without having to manage a lot of JavaScript, which I think what really, really resonated with kind of how I wanted to develop. And to kind of make it quite enjoyable, they also added a very quick and easy way I could install it in Rails. Okay, so what does it look like? So this is a kind of a Stimulus class. You've got your HTML there on the left and your JavaScript on the right. As you can see, we've kind of got some attributes and they're all relatively self-explanatory, like targets connected to targets, controller is connected to something over here and action does something. So let's go through. So the first thing is this controller. You can see the name of this file is counter_controller.js. So this is one of the magical things about Stimulus, is it has a little bit of magic when you set it up correctly, where it will choose the name of your controllers based on the file name. So when you see this name counter, you can kind of very quickly go, okay, I know where that's going to be defined. I can go look at its code without too much work, which I really like. That's one of my favorite things. It's so little, but it's so nice. Then you have these targets, and they are like saying to the JavaScript, these are elements I expect to be there. And when you define them, Stimulus gives you like a little helper class. So in this case, output target, which is it's kind of nice. It means you enforces it being there and without being too kind of overzealous. Finally, you have this action, and you can see kind of up here, you have the click. That's the action. That's when the user clicks a button, it's going to go to this controller and fire off this method. So it's not unapproachable, I think is how I would describe it. Let's give this a quick go. Yeah, you can see it working. It's going in here, updating the click count, and it's, you know, outputting how many times it's been clicked. Very nice. And it's not too much in the code as well, which is so, yeah, beautiful. Yeah, so when is it useful? So I've had a lot of luck with replacing jQuery with Stimulus on older sites. So a lot of that is going through, looking what I was doing with jQuery, realizing actually I don't need jQuery anymore. The browsers I'm working with are fairly well developed and are quite modern. and kind of going through and taking those like disorganized bits of code, making them nice and simple and very organized, was just a really wonderful experience. It's also very good when you want progressive enhancement. And that is when you kind of, you send down HTML to your user, which could work. If the JavaScript completely fails, the user could still perform the task you want them to. However, the JavaScript will come in, load, and it will just kind of add a little bit of sugar onto that experience. So for example, if you had a form and without the JavaScript, it will just submit to a page and the user will go on the merry way. As soon as the JavaScript kicked in, maybe you could do some Ajax submission and have a slightly more richer experience. It's also really good when you only want like a little bit of JavaScript. So maybe you don't have a complicated site and you just need a tiny little library, because it is only, I think it's 10 kilobytes after compression and minification, 30 kilobytes uncompressed. So really little. And you just want something just to say, okay, this is how we are going to organize our code to avoid the spaghetti of JavaScript, which can occur. The other really nice thing I've had is when I've worked in a very small team where everyone does everything, and Stimulus kind of very much complemented that in the sense of I could do the front end and the back end and add a bit of JavaScript, and it was all very approachable. So when is it not useful? So out there on the web, there are a lot of API-driven applications, and that is like, you've got your front-end code, which is going to call API number 1, 2, and 3 on the client side and do a lot of funky stuff, maybe generate lots of templates. And in those cases, I would still kind of consider React. It is just got much better toolage for that. It's what it's kind of made for. The other time I'd probably be not so keen on using Stimulus is if I'm using React and Vue already, and it's working. Like, there's no point changing a system just because, like, Stimulus is a lovely tool, but if something's working for you, don't change it. The other time I'd probably consider it, or like not use it even, is when I don't want to use JavaScript. Because I build a lot of websites, and quite often I just don't use any JavaScript at all. I just have HTML and CSS, and I check it out there, and that works. That makes me happy. And yeah. So how do we set up Stimulus in Rails? Well, it's actually really easy. First off, we make sure we've got Webpacker in our gem file by doing bundle add Webpacker. And that's the tool which kind of does all the Webpacker stuff, which is like the modern JavaScript for Rails. And then we just kind of say, okay, Webpacker, go off and install Stimulus. And once you run that, you'll get this output, which says, hey, I'm gonna append a bit of code here. I'm going to create these files and folders and then run yarn, and then I'm going to give you a nice emoji at the end. So really nice. So what this is going to do is it's going to modify this bottom application JS to add some like setup stuff. But most importantly, it's going to create this controllers folder. And if you remember from our example, we had a counter underscore controller.js. It would go in this folder, kind of right next to this one. And that's kind of all you need to know. We can just kind of get going and have a look at these files, and that should be enough. If you have any questions, my website is mikerodgers.io. On Twitter, I'm mikerodgers0. Thank you very much.